Hanna Fati is cleaning up the garbage. The 28-year-old Egyptian is gathering everything but the kitchen sink. These food scraps, though, are not going in the trash. They're being recycled upstairs on Hannah's roof, here in the slums east of Cairo, where Hannah is creating free energy.
We can use the same organic waste, which we already paid money for it when we buy it as a food, to make energy and also to save the environment from the fossil fuel.
This is how he does it, with a homemade biogas unit built from an old storage barrel. Inside the tank, bacteria from cow manure eats up the food. The byproduct is methane gas, which is funneled right back down to his kitchen, resulting in free power to heat more food and continue the cycle.
My philosophy is to create and use whatever you have to help yourself to be sustainable.
There's certainly plenty to choose from here in the gritty Manshiat Nasser district. Hanna is one of Egypt's zebalin, or garbage collectors. Most of Cairo's waste ends up here, in this landfill of a neighborhood. The zebalin sift through the debris, looking for hidden treasures to recycle, like these old toy motors, which contain copper wire that can be sold for around $2. Or, if you're Hanna, which can be used to build a solar panel, one that heats the water in his entire building, powered by Egypt's most abundant resource.
With this system, it's more safe and it's from the sun, so you pay nothing. And it's very clean. You never pollute the environment when you use it.
Even Hanna's radio is solar powered. Sustainable energy, he says, is the first step to giving his young son a healthier life. But going green in Egypt's sprawling capital is no simple task. Cairo is one of the most polluted cities in the Middle East. And following the recent uprising, the government is more focused on building a new nation, not cleaning the existing one.
People, most of them don't think about environment. They just want to make money. It doesn't matter if they protect or they pollute the environment. It doesn't matter.
But Hanna is trying to change that. Using technical skills he learned from an American organization, Solar Cities, Hanna is teaching his neighbors about sustainable living. Already, he's built 30 homemade solar panels and biogas units.
We have a lot of garbage everywhere. I think if people, they start to use their own garbage to make compost or methane gas, they will clean their streets, their homes. They will keep their environment very healthy for themselves and for their kids.
Hanna is also teaching his son about the environment. They're starting small, he says, building a cleaner Egypt, one rooftop at a time. Reporting for Global Post, this is John Jensen in Cairo.